show you how some printed information sources are organized. Things like this. But let's focus on the dictionary. Here is a page from a dictionary. You see that the words are in ABC order. Since information sources like this can have many, many pages and many, many words, the publisher adds things to guide you to the correct page. Let's take a look at these features.
Many dictionaries print the alphabet on the edge of each page. This helps you find the first letter of the word you are looking for. For example, the word edge begins with E. The letter C, followed by the letter D on the edges of the pages, lets you know that you are very close to finding words that begin with E. When you have found a page matching the letter your word begins with, look at the two words at the top of the page. Our example word, edge, falls between these two words in ABC order. That means you will find the definition of edge on this page. And there's the word edge at the top of the second column. The two words at the top of the page have a name. Do you know what they're called?
They're called guide words.
The two words at the top of the page are called what?
They're called guide words.
What are they called?
They're called guide words.
Excuse please, the two words, the ones at the top of the page, what did you call them?
Guide words.
Guide words! Guide words!
G-U-I-D-E-W-O-R-D-S.
Guide words.
I guess guide words are words that guide you to the right page so you can find the word you're looking for.
Bingo!
The job of guide words is to show you alphabetically what words you will find on the page. The guide word on the left tells you what the first word on the page is. In this example, that word is east. The guide word on the right tells you what the last word on the page is. In this example, that word is elbow. The rest of the words on the page are in ABC order, in between east and elbow.
In between? What does that mean?
The letter B is between the letter A and the letter C.
The number 3 is between 2 and 4.
The football is in between the basketball and the soccer ball.
Mendoza is in between Mrs. D and Mrs. Rodriguez.
Mrs. Nachman is in between Mrs. D and Mrs. Rodriguez.
Knobloch is in between Mrs. D and Mrs. Rodriguez.
Olenich is between Mrs. D and Mrs. Rodriguez.
And Mrs. D is before all of these letters that you see.
Mrs. Rodriguez is after all of these letters that you see.
They are all in between us.
In the dictionary, east comes before easy because T comes before Y in the alphabet. Got it?
I don't think she got it.
Okay, let's break it down. Begin with the first letter in each word. If they're the same, then ignore them. We've marked them out to make it easier. And move on to the second letter in each word. If the second letter in each word is the same, you can cross it out. And then move on to the third letter in each word. If the third letter in each word is also the same, then cross them off. and look at the fourth letter in each word. In this example, the fourth letter in each word is different. And since T comes before Y in the alphabet, the word east comes before the word easy in ABC order. The next word in ABC order is eat. We already know that east is first, before easy, so let's cross out east. Now we need to compare easy and eat. They have the same first letter and the same second letter, so we crossed those out. The third letter in each word is different, so these are the letters we need to compare. Which letter comes first in ABC order, S or T? S comes before T in the alphabet, so the word easy comes before the word eat in alphabetical order. Now it's your turn to try one. Why does eat come before echo in alphabetical order? You may want to pause the video for a moment to answer this question. The first letter in each word is the letter E, so we cross those out and move to the second letter in each word. Those letters are different, so we'll compare them. The letter A comes before C in the alphabet, so the word eat comes before echo in ABC order.
Let's try this concept at Abby Ziegman's first letter fruit stand.
Good morning, Abby Ziegman. How are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you. How are you?
I am wonderful. I have some boys and girls here with me, and they would like to understand how to use guide words. Could you tell us a little bit about how you have organized your first letter fruit stand?
Yes, of course. This is my first letter fruit stand. And as you can see, the first stand table has fruits from apple to fig and all of the things that are in between.
Now, what do you mean by in between?
Well, apple starts with A, so it is first. Fig starts with F, so it is last at this table. And the first letters that are in between A and F are in order between the two.
What kind of order?
Alphabetical order.
So A comes first, and then B for banana,
mm-hmm.
and then C for cantaloupe.
Yes.
And then E for eggplant.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, after eggplant comes fig. And that's all on this table. That's it.
That's it.
What if someone wants a grape?
Then you have to go to the next letter in the alphabet at my grape through orange table. And that will have grape first, orange last, and all of the letters that come between G and O.
So, do we finish with oranges? Is that the last fruit you have?
No. At the next table, we have peach through zucchini.
And so in between the P in peach and the W in watermelon, you say, comes the S in strawberry.
Yes.
Why, thank you so much for that lovely explanation.
Later that afternoon, a customer stops by Abby's alphabetized first letter fruit stand.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Is this the first letter fruit stand?
Yes, it is.
Well, I am in the market for a lemon. Can you tell me where I can find the lemons?
I sure can. If you find the table that has between grapes and oranges, you should be able to find the lemon.
So a lemon is between grape and orange, and it's there because L is between G and O?
Yes.
So if I look between G and O, I can find a lemon, and there's a lemon. How about that? Can I purchase this?
Yes, you may.
How much is this lemon?
$1.
A dollar? an expensive lemon, but fruit stand lady, I'll agree. And I'm only going to pay a dollar because it was so well organized. It was so easy for me to find. So there you go, and thank you very much.
You're welcome. Have a good day. You too. All right, back in my office. Just like the fruit at Abby's first letter fruit stand, words in a dictionary are alphabetized. And just as Abby used guide words to let her customers know which table has the fruit they want, dictionaries use guide words to tell you which page has the word you are looking for. And that concludes this episode of 20th Century Skills with Miss Biddy. Tune in next time for a lively discussion on the history of pencils. Ta-ta for now.
Okay, cut.
Oh, I got a cramp.
Oh, jeez.
Miss D is at the beginning. Before all of these letters.
Okay. One more time. Sorry.
I don't work with these guys. Are we covering our faces up for some real?
Are we doing this seriously?
No, I was joking.
These are going in the bloopers. Cover your face. Okay, there we go.
The football comes in between.
How about the football is between?
The Jersey accent.
You want me to talk?
Start this.
Fumble! You got better F?
F for fumble.
So they see the laces. Laces out. Laces out.
Okay. The letter B is between the letter A.
All right, cut.
Cut. Cut.
Dearie, you've skipped the letter D. Was there a reason for that?
I don't have a fruit for that.
Oh, that would make perfect sense. Thank you. Did your fig supplier not show up this time?
They have already been purchased.
Ah, they were here. Mm-hmm. Well, you're a very good fruit stand purveyor, yes?
Yes, thank you.
I'm not aware that zucchini is a fruit. Did you do that just because you wanted the letter Z?
Yes.
How much is this lemon?
$1.
Kim, okay, $1? Okay. How much is this lemon?
$1.
So that $1 is between 10 cents and $2, right? Okay.